sides, mister. So, ladies and gentlemen, we back.
Yeah.
Welcome to Retro Gaming. Mm-hmm. And we are just keeping the classic hits rolling. So, we were previously playing Breath of the Wild. I am now a Zelda fan. I don't know why he keeps doing that, but I'm going to just let it roll with it.
I mean, nobody can say that title without doing it.
And it's probably going to work. And so we've dived into one of the best hits in Nintendo. Now we're going to dive into one of the greatest hits in PlayStation.
Ever. If anything, this is what made the PlayStation.
Yes.
It's this one.
Yes.
Yeah, man.
We are playing Final Fantasy VII.
The first one that counts.
The first one that counts. Yes.
It's just like Star Wars.
Yeah, man. Listen, I'll never forget the very first time I laid eyes on Final Fantasy VII. I was at my friend's house. His older brother and his friends were playing it. And I would try to get to my friend's house every single weekend just to see them play this game. Because I was so invested in the story. And the characters, I wanted to see if they were going to get a new summon because I'd only seen Shiva and Ramuf and Titan and Ifrit. I've only saw those three summons. Mm-hmm. And then here, later on to find out, there's almost like, what, 20? Almost like 20 summons that you can get in this game, including Knights of the Round Table, which a lot of people never get a chance to get.
Is that the hardest one?
It's one of the hardest ones. You have to like breed a golden chocobo, or as he calls it, a chikaru.
Chikaru.
It's not a chikaru.
So what is it called?
It's called a chocobo.
Well, that sounds stupid.
That does.
So we're going to call it a chikaru.
That sounds like a chocolate bar.
Right.
Wow.
Chikaru just sounds right.
Listen, okay, this is Square Enix. They know what they're doing. They named this animal a chocobo. You should respect the name of it.
A lot of credit.
I can also respect that they would think that as a gamer and fan, I would have a free mind to go, that name sounds stupid. So we're going to say, what word sounds like when you see the picture of it? Chikaru.
I went down
chocobo
with chikaru, but I got introduced to chikaru at the same time as Assassin's Creed, those things, so I associate the two together.
Okay.
Chikaru.
So be it.
A lot of unpronounceable names on these credits.
Yeah, man.
Listen, man. I wonder if all these guys returned for the remake.
Man.
You think they went back and grabbed everyone up to give them that actual nostalgic feeling of like, yo, we've been, look at the explosion.
Technically, it's not like you're changing the script. They better not have.
Run it. Let's get into it.
Let's get into it.
Let's do this.
Let's hit it. New game. Oh, wait, we won't overwrite, right?
If we go, let's just go new game if you guys want to, even though I have went back and played it very recently. I'm pretty far in the story again.
You don't want us to erase it though.
No, but if you go new game, you'll be fine.
Okay, bet.
Yeah, you can just save it on another.
I thought you were like, I mean, I worked really hard on it.
Right. I was like, yeah.
I've been trying to get a perfect run, and you guys just want to ruin it. Okay, fine. Jesus, man. Jesus, dog.
Man,
need any of this? So when they ported this over to the PS4, as you guys can see, if you click the L3 button, it makes everything go way faster in the battles.
What do you mean?
Ah.
So, like, you know how it was time-based battles? Mm-hmm. You had to wait for the little bar to click all the way over. When you click L3, it just makes the entire game faster.
Wow.
So it's not as
that doing?
It's just not, the game's not as drawn out.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
No. What is it doing when you L3? You said it ports to something different?
No, when they ported Final Fantasy to the PS4, they added that feature.
Got it.
So, yeah,
okay, so this is official. I thought this was like a Kadeem hack.
No.
Right.
This is not a Zordon.
This is right off the PS network.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, man.
Okay, we in the stars right now.
Right.
We out here. Galaxy, in the beginning type shit.
True story. I had a cracked version of this game for a long time.
Cracked?
The disc was cracked.
Yeah.
Oh, got it.
And I tried everything. Tried everything to make it work.
Did
I
it not
spit
get
on
past
it.
A certain
I cleaned it. I went and got a
you
DVD
spit on it
cleaner.
Before you cleaned it?
Maybe after, not sure. I tried everything. And I would get to this part and it would start slowly. And man, for at least a month, I just tried to get it working. And it never did. So I had to go out and buy a new one.
So is somebody talking right now?
No. You're literally just hearing music. And then we are introduced to the...
Our subtitles on.
To one of the greatest video game characters of all time, Aerith.
Good old Aerith.
Yeah, man. Aerith lives. Shout out to Wreck-It Ralph. Wreck-It Ralph has an Easter egg of her in the movie, which was really cool.
Shout out to all that hair she got.
That long ponytail.
Hair to the back, called it Rosa Parks.
Man, you think it's weave? That's all her?
Man. You got like a girl next door, let's have a picnic vibe. I don't really have, see, those girls have a lot of hair.
This city though, like just.
Like a futuristic.
Welcome to Midgar, fellas.
Wow. Trash city.
Yes.
The city layout is like a pizza.
Yes.
I don't like it.
Yes, it is.
I hope the future ain't like that. You know what I mean?
Right.
It seems like the depictions of the future is like either very mechanical like this,
steampunk,
or very like clean and in the clouds, you know?
Yeah.
All right, so now we're going, look like Agrabah.
The bowels.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We in here, man.
I feel like Abe's Odyssey tried to copy this aesthetic and they failed.
I don't know if they failed.
Oh,
let's just accept it.
Oh, they fighting. Bow. Oh, you failed. You died.
Yeah. Wedge and Biggs, and Jess, Barrett, and of course,
the
legendary.
Come on, newcomer. Follow me.
He'll never be stopped, man. Like, he's that good.
Let's go.
Make sure you hit the X on the guy that's over there, because you can get a potion.
Oh, shit. I'm in a fight.
The battle begins.
I'm in a fight.
Exo, that's all we know him as.
Hey, what are they?
You get to name him in a few.
Oh, man, they shot me. I'm gonna attack, though. Attack you.
You're getting punched in the face.
You dead. Come on.
That damn Buster sword.
What if they low-key are just a little bit Resident Evil-ish. I never noticed that.
Oh, yeah.
Like Jill, huh?
Yeah. Very early Jill drawings.
Yeah. Yeah. Did not catch that at all.
Put I was just like, wait, what is what? Is there a connection? I kind of had like a brain fart. Like, is there a universe connection?
Capcom Square Enix. So
is
no.
That the, you know, the police uniform in this fictional world?
Right here,
yep.
Right here.
Hit him with the X.
Get a little secret potion. Which
you bing! Receive.
Love it.
A potion.
That's what I'm talking about.
Where we going?
That's a shot of Henny. They try to make it a kid friendly. That's a shot right. Of something. You got to have a homeless man. Guy.
All right, y'all, what we doing? What we doing gang, out here gang. On the set? On the set, bitch.
All right, let's already get into it. Live action Final Fantasy. Who's playing Cloud?
I would honestly want
to
see a CG movie.
We have.
Like a in theaters?
Yeah.
Really?
Advent
Children?
Yeah.
That was in like theaters?
Yeah.
I don't go to the movies.
We know.
You're not a movie goer. Pat waits to hear the reviews on the films and be like,
No, I wait to see them in the comfort of my own home.
Respect.
That's what you do.
Yeah.
I would get that. Yeah.
You know how long it took for me to not talk about Avengers with him?
Damn. I just, like, I don't care when it's in movies. I want to wait. I will wait until it's. I can do it at home.
And you still haven't seen Parasite.
Oh, I haven't seen Parasite.
Oh.
I haven't either.
Go see Parasite. However you can. I believe it's on Amazon now. You can stream it. Go see Parasite.
I had no idea if people were waiting on me to see it.
Yeah, man. I think you're really gonna take a lot from that film. I can't wait to hear your breakdown about it. I think you're gonna catch a lot of things that I think went over a lot of people's heads on the first watch for sure.
Okay.
Yeah, man.
Well, wow. You used to be a soldier, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Not everyone, not every day you found
that
one, in a group like Avalanche.
Mm-hmm.
Avalanche.
Soldier.
Avid Children was in theaters?
Yeah.
Probably a limited release, but for sure went to theaters, mm-hmm. And then we got our DVD.
They've actually had two movies.
Yeah, Spirits Within, which was a waste of time.
You guys saw both of these in theaters?
Seven had two movies. So you had Avid Children, and then what's the other one with the, what is his name? Dressed in Red, got the gun with the hand and shit.
Dressed in Red, Vincent?
I think that's Vincent. Vincent got his own movie too.
Dredge of Cerberus? That was a DVD, that was a video game. We gotta look that up. Let's get into it.
Yeah.
So yes, of course, we would love to another live or a CGI film of Final Fantasy to tell another story in that universe. But if we did have a live action, where are we going?
I feel like I need one.
Really?
No,
I don't.
All right.
I like the CG.
Yeah. I'm good with the CGI myself.
It's literally like how I feel about Link. Like I don't think I'm ready to see a human one. A human cloud.
Man, that's gonna happen.
It's gonna happen
eventually.
And it's
gonna happen.
And the same thing that they did to Goku, where it just looked like bad cosplay, we're gonna have to suffer through that. Because no, like indie film has gotten Link right. Link looked dumb as hell every time he's in live action.
Here's the thing: if you do Link, you would literally have to do it based off a person who is a no name that you fit for Link. He could have not played. He can't play in anything else.
Gotta grab him up.
Like, literally, like Harry Potter. They went got someone and made him look just like, every time you see Daniel Radcliffe, like, yo, I get you've done all this other stuff, but you are Harry Potter.
But you're Harry Potter.
Always.
I feel messed up saying that, but I get it.
I mean, it is what it is.
So we can play while we're talking.
Oh, yeah, my fault. Oh, I got it.
Can we name him something different?
No!
Name him something different!
Are you crazy? I've never done that, ever.
What?
I do
it. I played Ocarina of Time as Snake once, and I've never forgiven myself.
Oh, my God.
Nor should you.
That's a great name.
I had just played Metal Gear Solid, and I'm like, I'm gonna be Snake. And then midway through the game, I was like, this is a mistake. I'm never changing the main characters again.
I have a tradition of changing the main character's name to my name, yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
I do as well.
I'm in there.
So full of yourselves. I did that in Pokemon, and then I was like, you know what? I'm gonna give the character that they wrote it shine.
Let's name him Patrick.
Nah. Fat?
Let's name him Patrick.
This is blasphemous.
Farah.
Did you?
I was wondering, like, where are you going with this?
No. How'd you get to Far Cry?
I saw P-H-A-R, and that was it.
How do you spell Far Cry?
F-A-R-C-R-Y.
I'm just saying, that could be a way to say far.
Thank you, Pat.
I got it.
Thank you, brother.
Stop.
Trying to make it seem like I'm illiterate here. Stop this. Stop this. Stop this. Stop this blasphemy.
Yeah.
Name don't even fit him. It fits you. It don't fit him.
Cleo
definitely fits this character.
None of this fits.
That's X. Wow. Let's go. We gotta at least get to another battle. You gotta try.
Imagine
to at least
fighting a nigga who pulls out a big sword. He's like, I'm Cleo. Nigga, what? That makes no sense. Doesn't even make sense.
When has Patrick ever been the hardest name in the book?
Not at all. That's why
good.
I said
all right.
Cloud.
Yeah,
that's why I went with Cloud.
That was not my point.
All right, we're running in here.
Barrett. I'm really excited to play as Barrett in the new one.
Oh, who's this guy? Sam? You guys gonna change his name to Arthur?
Yeah.
Jax. His name is John Henry.
Already. I've been waiting on this all my life since we were back.
What are you gonna name Barrett?
Chuck.
What you say now, Chuck?
This is going to be magical.
This is a disgrace. I just want you guys to know.
This is amazing. This is a truly incredible way of starting this game off.
What you say now, Chuck?
What you say now, there, Chuck?
All right.
Is analog stick good with this? Or is it still D-pad?
No, I think you can run with analog in this. Okay. Hit L3 when you get a jam.
No, right.
And yeah, take off. He runs a little bit faster. See?
Oh, man.
See what I'm saying?
The crack speed.
Yeah.
Oh, we in a fight.
Get to it.
Oh, I hate this.
You don't like this.
I think it's better for when you're like, when you're trying to level up your character.
When you're on cocaine, yeah.
Okay. Or that.
Come on, I got 7 minutes. Let's play through all 8 discs.
I'm almost finished. Your nose is bleeding. I don't care. I collected gil.
Yeah, man.
Always down to collect the gil. I want to see it.
Alert.
Yeah, man. Let me get my moves on, man.
Down. Yeah, there you go.
That's the one thing I will say I hate about this game, but now I actually love about this game.
Oh,
I don't go with him?
Nope.
I'm in a fight now. Okay.
What did you love or hate about this game?
Because at first it was like, it didn't really tell you where to go. So you'd be like, yo, am I lost? And you just wasn't really looking.
Yeah.
And like, here you gotta pay attention.
I feel like this game and Pokemon were the only like turn-based games that I really
enjoyed?
Accepted. Other than that, I wouldn't say I liked RPGs, but then it's like these two are for sure. Those two are classic RPG format, and it's like those are the best.
Yeah.
Pokemon Stadium too.
Man. What am I fighting?
There's a little parrot over there.
Wow, really?
No.
He lived.
He
was like, really? I'm the last guy in the group?
They put Iago back in Final Fantasy.
How heavy you think this damn sword is? I always wondered.
Ridiculously heavy.
Ridiculous.
Imagine breaking your wrist 20 times a week during training.
Ridiculously heavy.
Just swing it.
To the reactor.
It seemed very inefficient.
Yeah.
Like it might be the
worst
weapon.
But I heard it breaks
weapon.
Up and shit.
It what?
It breaks up though.
Breaks up?
Yeah. The sword breaks up.
Oh.
Remember in Advent
Children? Oh, in Advent Children, yeah. Huh. You're right. Yeah, he does. Like in that one, they made it seem like his Buster sword held all the other forms of his sword. I was like, all right, I guess I'll take it.
Didn't it like turn like turn into like light and then separate and shoot down or some shit like that?
Go off.
Yeah. Who was that? Who was he fighting in that? Was that Sephiroth?
Sephiroth.
Yeah.
Sephiroth or the clones that they put, like Kadaj and someone else?
No. He did that to Sephiroth. Because they turned into Sephiroth.
He just absorbed Chuck.
Yeah, man.
Say now, Chuck.
What you say now, that Chuck?
Say now, that Chuck.
Like, I'm going to just chill inside Cloud. Right? He just climbs up inside you.
Imagine how much heavier it is to carry his big ass around now, bro.
Well, now Cloud can say nigga. I don't think we ever explored that.
He has a valid point.
By the rules of, I guess, life.
Oh, man.
If you absorb a big black man, you can say nigga.
You are now been granted the permission to say nigga.
That's why he was gifted with the Buster Sword. He's like, you are the chosen one. Enjoy.
Enjoy.
To jump really quick back to the Zelda live action, right? Do you feel that, I know this is kind of a cheat because we've kind of seen him with the ears already, but a young Orlando Bloom in Lord of the Rings as Legolas, wasn't that kind of in that same realm?
Nope.
He was blonde, he had the ears?
Nope.
You know why Link is such a tough cast?
Why?
Link, the animators did a really good job of making him look soft. But right. When he's fighting, he looks fierce as fuck.
Okay.
And actors, like, that's hard to pull off. Either you, like, Tom Holland or, like, Orlando Bloom.
Yeah.
Or you're just, like, a Hugh Jackman-looking dude that's just cast as the tough guy. I don't know a lot of people who... The only person who could really bring it on is Keanu Reeves, and he don't look like Link. Keanu Reeves was the first guy who was kind of just, like, chill, and, like, he seemed, like, kind of soft. But then, like, when he was really fighting, you believed it.
Big facts.
Because even Will Smith, to a certain point, when he's like super tough, you're like, I saw you get beat up on a basketball court in Philadelphia.
Oh,
by a bunch of like 90s thugs. Like.
Real talk.
So I don't know, it's tough.
Well, another fight.
But
another
you know fight. It's going to be Tom Holland.
Yeah.
And we've talked about this on previous episodes. Cloud we do feel like Tom Holland is the go-to.
He's going to be Cloud too.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
They're gonna Kevin Hart him with all the young white roles.
Damn.
Hit him with the ice. Put the necklace around him.
There's so many great materials in this game. It's so cool.
What's y'all favorite move?
Ooh. Favorite summon might be Hades.
Ooh yeah, Hades.
Favorite summon Hades. Favorite materia / magic might be Comet. And that's about
Comet, you get fairly early, right?
I want to say in the second disc.
Okay.
Yeah. But when it started like upgrading, it went from fire to fire two to fire three, and then they were all upgraded. I'm like, yo, this is great. And they all look different.
All right, jump.
I'm for sure thinking of something in the first disc.
I'm climbing down the ladder.
At E3 this year, there was a cosplayer. There were two cosplayers. One is Cloud and one is Tifa. And
hate him.
What?
Always hate him.
Well, I was gonna say he looked good. Shout out to you, brother. You looked great.
The hair. Unless you really got a good stylist, the hair usually throws off the rest of the costume.
Because it's usually a freaking wig.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. It's usually like some big. Random Japanese hair, and the outfit could be dope, but it's like the hair just throws it off a lot.
Facts. Whoever the kid was at E3 with him and his girl, they came as the couple. Y'all look great.
That would be cool.
Rolling up together as a couple with that?
In the world of gaming?
Yeah.
Come on, no.
Save point, do I say?
Go for it, brother. We're going to take this really slow, though, so triangle. Go back to it. No, you got to go back and hit X on it. Boom, all right, here we go. Triangle.
This game too, Will. Will was having a lot of trouble with the
circle.
The menu in Breath of the Wild.
And triangle. Save.
I was here.
Yeah, but to save, you didn't. Okay, now we're gonna take this mad slow. Save one.
You sure?
Let's go save two for you. Let's just go ahead and cross that over. There we go. Look at you, brand, open space. You can't mess nothing up. Ain't no one thing getting deleted.
The memory card was a really nice piece of hardware.
Talk about the PlayStation memory card.
I liked them.
I thought it was the coolest thing ever. You didn't have to bring your whole console to your friend's house. You could literally just bring that. Mm-hmm. If they have the game, you plug in, your character's
all
locked.
I mean, if you show a kid now, they'd be like, fuck you. Like, it would make no sense because they're like, fam, I have this little thing And I never need a memory card, but if Facts. You were alive before the memory card and you lived through 6-hour pauses.
Talk about
and
it.
And overnight, heat your PlayStation, you could fry your scrambled eggs on the next morning.
Talk about it, Pat.
Just because you could not save it, but you also did not know how to pass the level. The memory card was amazing.
Yes, it was.
Seeing us build out gaming, we saw the analog sticks come in,
yeah.
Then the memory card, then the rumble pack.
Yep.
All that stuff was beautiful to see. It's like I feel like ancient.
That was also your first look into classism. Because you knew how much money a person really had based off of those. Because please believe it when I tell you, I was an 8 megabyte memory card holder.
With them 16s, yeah. Though, baby. You had them 16s on me.
But you could have multiple 8s. I had multiple 8s.
Yeah, I had multiple 8s.
Like, where is my game on? You just have like a sea of memory.
But yo, when the homie walked in with a 32, came in with a 32 megabyte on us, I was like.
Yeah, baby.
He was like, I got all my games on here. It was 6, but hey, it was still it.
Yeah.
You miss.
These guys were like real deal infiltrating. Like these are not just rent-a-cops.
And shout out to the third-party companies who then started making memory cards. Like of course you had the PlayStation exclusive on the PlayStation actually branded ones. But then Mad Catz came out and had like so many different colors. I had a yellow one.
It had a yellow memory card?
Yeah, a yellow PlayStation memory card from Mad Catz.
Yeah.
It had everything on it. It had all my
saves. I remember Mad Catz.
Right? It was like a third party.
They made everything.
A third party manufacturer to everything. Does anyone remember the PlayStation multi-tap?
No.
I remember that. I do remember
the
that.
The multi-tap allowed you to have up to 4 players on a PlayStation console. It was built like a V. Let me pull it.
There were games that let you do that?
I don't know which one it was for, but for sure PlayStation manufactured a PlayStation multi-tap. Check this out.
Heck yeah, I'm going to take your potion. Give me that potion. Yeah, give me that.
There it is.
Oh, another fight. Getting a lot of fights.
Somebody's selling those on eBay right now. $14.
Oh, it's a back attack. It's a back attack.
A whole multi-tap.
I don't know any games that even.
Yeah, I wonder which one it would play. Let's find out.
I don't remember any games that like my friends were like.
Oh, I got the limit. I'm brave.
Let's do it.
Watch
let's
this.
Do it.
Watch this. Watch this. Oh, it's about to go down.
Damn.
Love it. Love it.
God, I can't wait to see
Monkey
that
ninja.
I can't wait to see it. See it.
Hogs of War, Speed Freaks, Ape Escape, NBA Hoops.
Ape Escape was crazy. Ape Escape was 4 player?
That's what it's saying, yeah. Mm-hmm. That you could use the multi-tap with, that was the one. 2-on-2 Ice Challenge, a hockey game. WWF In Your House was another multi-tap accessible game. So yeah, they had work.
That's crazy.
Yeah, man.
I just realized that all of PlayStation really had this random aesthetic of like these metal, you know what I mean? Like this looks a lot like you said, Oddworld. It also looks very Metal Gear Solid. Like all of PlayStation was kind of rocking with this weird, like apocalyptic look.
They had a style to it. Watch out.
We know who that is.
This is just a reactor.
We know who it is.
What's wrong?
I can't see Chuck up there.
Chuck?
I can't.
You say that at Chuck?
I can't.
What's
do
wrong,
this.
Pharaoh? Hurry up. Did you say that at Chuck? Yeah, my bad. Sorry.
One thing I loved about Final Fantasy is the fact that you could go and get better weapons, but you had to find them.
Yeah.
You had to find, like Barrett gets some really incredible arm guns.
He does.
Tifa gets some really cool gloves.
Oh shit.
Okay, so do you know how to beat this boss?
I do not.
Okay. So,
but
it's a machine, so what?
Bolt.
Hey, Barrett, we go. Off top.
Oh, good shit, because that's what I picked.
When his tail goes up, you do not attack.
Okay. There we go. His tail is not up.
Nope. All right.
So we didn't shot him, though. So he's mad.
He's about to hit you with that rifle.
He is, and he did not miss. His tail is not up.
You're on Chuck right now. Hit circle and go left and go hit change. So that makes Barrett take a step back since he's a long-range fighter. His normal attack will take away more now.
Okay.
I had to find that out later in life. I'm like, yo, that matters?
Wait, he sure did.
Yeah.
I don't get it.
So because Barrett is a long-range fighter and he has a gun, mm-hmm. by default, they put all the characters in the same row.
Right.
But just that one shift and him stepping back.
Makes him stronger?
Makes him stronger.
It sure is.
Wow. Do you have to step back before every time or just once?
No, just once.
So all long-range fighters then, huh?
Yes, sir. Okay. So Vincent, Yuffie, Sid is not alone, and nope, Kate Sith isn't. I totally keep forgetting about Kate Sith.
Oh man, Chuck, be careful. Oh shit.
It says attack while it's tails, right?
It's gonna counterattack with its laser. So don't take. All right, don't listen to Klee.
No, I didn't do that.
Don't listen to Klee. Just take that. Just take the, take it.
No, he missed.
He missed you.
Yeah, I didn't. Chuck.
Go right and hit defend. Right, defend. There we go. Hit it again.
Yeah. I didn't select attack.
Yeah.
I'm just letting everybody know.
Yeah. They made Barret look ridiculously big.
Yeah.
And go for it. Now start attacking.
Okay.
Like the Rock.
The Rock.
Yeah.
He's also ridiculously big though.
He's crazy.
The fact that he works out 6 hours a day.
Shout out to his cousin, who is his stunt double, who is just as big as he is.
Yep.
Tanawa.
Yep.
Big shout out to you, brother.
Who is that?
Hey, The Rock's cousin is his stunt double. His
I already know The Rock has some crazy big cousins.
His name is Tanawa.
Can you imagine The Rock getting like his, he's like, all right, I'll have my family pull up. And you're like, your family?
Mm-hmm.
The Rock looked like he got a sister with him. Some big Samoan woman that'll just.
Man.
Mop the floor with you.
Man, RIP the soul man, man.
Yeah,
oh,
man.
Yeah, that's right.
The Rock's father passed away not too long ago, man. Incredible wrestling career with by himself.
Yeah.
You know, he went to the WWE Hall of Fame.
Yep. Right.
Yeah, man.
Birthed the biggest wrestler ever.
Right.
And, movie star.
And also was the first black tag team champion.
So was.
With the homie, the Atlas.
Yeah, man.
Listen, Tony, man.
I've literally never heard of a wrestler named the Atlas.
Tony Atlas, man.
We're almost done with this boss battle.
Crazy story about him.
Defeated. The Nick Cannon video, what?
Orlando Brown?
Apparently, Orlando Brown said, and that's not, this is what I heard in the streets.
You got that dome.
That, apparently Nick Cannon was sucking dick after 12 on Orlando Brown.
After 12?
After 12.
Like after that night?
Yeah, because you know, only sluts suck dick after 12.
And then, what about a good afternoon sucking?
Now that's just a good woman, from what I've been told. Because then you can still go get your, oh nigga, the time, I gotta go.
You gotta dip.
Now you wanna go into crack time.
Yeah, hit it, but the time goes faster anyway.
Yeah, I was thinking. Yeah. That'd be hella unfair.
Making my way downtown.
You didn't save.
Yeah.
It's all good. What do I think about it? Listen, man. Orlando Brown has had plenty of antics for the last, two and a half years? It's sad to see what I think the go-to label is for any young actor who was in the industry, very young, successful.
Oh, yeah.
And then they grow older. And then, when they don't have the same amount of opportunities, when they don't have the same amount of money, and they get around some other shit, they smoke the wrong thing and it just messes with their head. Now, the crazy part about it is hearing Orlando in that video, he's the same person as he was as a kid. Mm-hmm. It's the same sense of humor. It's weird. It's the same shit. Everything. He never grew out of, which isn't a bad thing. It's a great, talent to have, to never grow out of that thing and still see the world like that. But for him to take a shot at Nick Cannon the way he did in that form, like, bro, he said that him and Raven did this and blah, blah, blah. All we can hope for is that man to get his life together in some way or fashion.
The thing is, it's like, first of all, you have to take into account, like, the history of this. You know what I mean? His, I don't know if it's his brother or his cousin, but somebody said that a lot of people in his family don't want anything to do with him because He just burnt every bridge, and he would literally be driving around with people and he'd stop, turn the radio off and be like, I think my dad is Will Smith. So like, when you think of just random things like this, then it's just like, okay, if you didn't know already, it's obviously like a fake story. Then the other part of me is just thinking like, why the fuck would Nick Cannon suck your dick? Like, in that situation, like, nigga, Nick Cannon is like rich as hell. You'd probably be sucking Nick Cannon.
I read the original caption, I thought that's what it was.
The dark story of Hollywood, like,
yeah, man.
Don't make Nick Cannon the dick sucker.
Right.
You know Nick Cannon's worked way too hard, and between y'all two positions,
speak facts.
The story I would believe is you suck dick to be on Wildin' Out or some shit.
Speak facts.
Not that Wait. Nick Cannon, Nick Cannon got Wildin' Out girls.
Facts.
Where are you going?
I was pressing, so let me go.
You gotta go hit X.
Yeah, that was, very strange, but at the end of the day, I don't think anybody's really walking away with this thinking that Nick Cannon is actually out here sucking.
I know I wasn't.
Yeah.
So you, you probably worked with Orlando a lot back in the day. Were you guys just in the same circle?
Same circle. I've ran into him several times.
Okay.
With the success of That's So Raven, which is even looking back to then, you could kind of see as the seasons went on, mm-hmm. that he was trying to rebel so much against that system of being a Disney, because he's, I'm a real nigga, I'm from the streets, mm-hmm. this, that, and the other, and it's just like, but you can't tell that to someone like him.
But Disney.
But thank you. You can't tell that to someone like him who's like, yo, but you're doing this. Like, yeah. You're better off, bro.
Yeah.
But as you see time was going on through the That's So Raven season, you can see he got a lot bigger. As far as his weight, mm-hmm. There was tattoos starting to show up, like in things. It's like, what are you doing? Mm-hmm. Now, how do you check a Disney kid walking into set smelling like weed then? Now, maybe.
Really?
Then?
What do you mean?
Like,
it was
I don't know
to
the
handle.
Difference.
It was easier to handle. Now you got social media and all that stuff, so somebody can see it and then post that stuff.
Yeah.
Anybody. Then especially like you said, with bridges you done burned and stuff like that, yeah. Ain't no telling who looking at you and who catching you doing this stuff, and you just giving them the ammunition for it.
Oh, you let Pharaoh die?
He died?
Yeah, you didn't heal him?
You're using this crackhead mode.
You got 3 minutes left, by the way.
I know.
You're not going to make it out of here.
He's just pacing back and forth on this beam.
You got to hit X when you go up to the high beam.
I've been waiting for you to pass these.
I am there.
Like, oh, you're right. Yeah, left.
You see, I'm telling you. Yeah. See what y'all be doing?
Dip, hit the elevator, we gotta go. Yeah.
See what y'all be doing, man?
So like, yeah, man, here. It's sad to see, and like you said, poster child Pat, this is like, that's, they expect that from you. You're expected to do that. If you were successful at that age.
Wait, how we wake him up?
You see Aaron Carter and shit like that? Man. Like that.
Aaron got a whole face tat.
How do we wake him
so
up?
Stupid.
Oh, it's a girl's face?
Producer, ain't it?
Wow.
I gotta go look this up.
I didn't even want to know that.
I gotta look this up.
Hey man, think of the people at home. Turn this crackhead mode off. It's giving me a headache.
I don't even know how to get out.
Down, through there. I'll hit the potion. You can go get the, you're about to run out of time. Go back to my guy. Okay, so that's how you wake up Cloud, the Phoenix Den. You're gonna blow up with this entire section of Midgar.
Probably.
Why do I think he said Nick Cannon?
Attention.
That and
he just said Jesse from Foot Locker, he wouldn't have gone viral.
I think you can tell that there's people like hyping him. Just like you look at the Antonio Brown situation. There's people via social media who are feeding that ego. Like, yo, you're hilarious. Your music's amazing. Keep dropping album. So they're feeding it. So you can imagine he saw one comment on Instagram Live that said, Why aren't you on Wildin' Out? You're just as funny as up there. And that just kind of sparked him to be like, well, Nick don't want me up there. Nick don't want me up there.
Is that how it started?
I'm assuming that's how that would start.
Wow.
Wasn't he on there though?
So then,
Where am I going?
You said that you saw him every now and then. Did you sort of see the randomness as it, progressed?
I saw that the kid that I saw on TV when I wasn't even in the business was the same guy. Like, he did not change.
No, not now, but back then.
No, that's what I'm saying.
Oh, okay.
Even back then, I saw the kid who I watched on TV, doing these guest star roles and, like, being the smart mouth kid. Uh-huh. He was that in real life.
Oh, I see what you mean.
You see, like, that's how he really was. Uh-huh. And he never could turn, he doesn't turn that off. And as you can see, even from Instagram and all these posts, he's now taking it to the level of, well, I'm that nigga.
Yeah.
So you can imagine that talent of just being the smart mouth kid through all these years. Take off.
Let me get this a spin.
Yes, man.
Let me
roam the streets of Midgar.
Vanessa Hudgens broke up with her man recently, fellas.
She was seeing someone?
She did, yeah. She was with some white boy. She was with some white guy. And I played the sidelines for a long time. I didn't, as a respect to that relationship, they were together for like 7-8 years. So I never, voiced my concern about wanting to put my bid in, if you will. She recently became single, and then some photos came out of her maybe a day after the Bad Boys premiere with Kyle Kuzma from the Los Angeles Lakers. Now,
they work fast.
They work God real damn, fast. Do they work fast. Damn, when they hit the mark.
There's a celebrity chef. He's worked for like a lot of athletes.
Yeah.
He said it was funny seeing how many girls rotated the same houses. They'd see him and always be like, fuck,
are we
gonna cook it again?
Like, yeah.
That's amazing.
Athletes work faster than anybody.
So. Yeah.
That is hilarious.
Look up and you're WCW courtside. And you're like, what?
Damn.
She's broke.
Not anymore.
Just draft.
See, they don't air that
first round. Hey, yeah, man.
They do not air that
draft. A bunch of hats that just have different dicks on them. I decided to take my talents to the Los Angeles Lakers.
Oh, shit. Amazing. Absolutely amazing.
That Southern Charm has been drafted to the Miami Heat.
Yeah, man. Put on the flight.
For a 3-year contract.
Fly out. Put on. True story, man. Pat, true ass story, brother. I was at a studio with one of my friends, rapper, right? You brought that up and it reminded me of a story. At the studio with a friend of mine, rapper, right? He got a girl in there with him. They dip off and do their thing in the little side section of the studio. I know what happened, whatever. I gotta go take a meeting downtown. I'm in Santa Monica at the time.
I gotta go take a meeting.
This was at least 5 to 6 years ago.
Yeah.
I got to dip off. So I dap him up real quick. Boom. I was like, yo, I'm good. We'll see you next time. So I start heading downtown. I stop for gas. I stop for food. I'm headed to the other homie house, who is also a rapper.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I see this.
She beat me to the other homie's house.
What'd you do before?
I was at the studio with one homie,
uh-huh,
who's a rapper.
Uh-huh.
On the way downtown, I stopped and got gas and got food.
Oh, got
I pull up to the other homie house in downtown.
Wow.
The chick beat me to his place.
Wow.
I couldn't believe it. The look in her eyes when she saw me.
What's crazy is, like, if you a hoe, that's fine. But you daddy fishing of a hoe?
Man.
You can't go home and shower?
No.
Nope.
Give me that respect.
She Listerine the throat and kept it moving.
Give me that respect. If you want to do all that, fine. Shower first.
No.
You dirty bitch.
It was, what's up, brother? What's up, man? Well, we walking. I walk into past the hallway. Now here we are in the living room area. And sure enough, I see the back of her head on the couch. And I go around. And normally when you got women around in that type of setting, you at least try to just make, you know, the tension. He's like, yo, I'm not involved or whatever the fuck you got going on. Just, hey, nice to meet you. And you keep it moving. At least you just show this respect there.
Yeah.
I come around the corner and see a face. I'm like, nice to meet you. Smiling the whole time and go to the kitchen.
How'd she say?
Hey, 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 that's it.
Hey again. Nice to see you again.
Bro, this had to be within a 35 to 40 minute time span.
Yo.
That I just saw you at the studio with the other homie.
No, she took a whore's bath and headed over.
Damn.
That happened, brother. Blew my mind.
But it's like...
Yo, he did.
Pat, you getting off. Man. Didn't I tell you stop attacking
I was into
them?
The horror story.
The horror story.
Yo, that's grindy as fuck.
That blew my mind because it's just like, are you busy or something? Like, go grab some food.
No. Nah.
Oh, I'm dead.
Scarfing.
Horror story.
Yeah, that happened, brother.
Wow.
I'll never forget it. Damn, they gave you got a trophy for that. Failure is an option.
Wow.
He failed too.
But I guess he failed after the boss battle. You died during the boss battle. It gave you clear instructions.
I mean, people don't talk about that enough. Failure is an option.
It is.
We've been saying the wrong things in movies this whole time. Absolutely is an option. Every single time.
Hey, you got a trophy for
you
it.
You pick up the guitar, you could fail at it.
I picked up a guitar.
But would you want a reward for it?
Absolutely. You wouldn't?
No. If I failed, I fucking failed.
Let me fail in peace.
Imagine completely giving up on something and somebody showing up like, hey man, good job. Yeah, you can just fuck
yeah,
up.
Imagine that.
Nah, I'm good on like, that. No, don't rub that in. That's a hard feeling.
Could you imagine that?
Nah.
You get $30?
Yeah, like a fucking failed marriage and somebody walk up to you, hey.
I wasn't gonna
congratulations,
do it.
Anyway. Congratulations, though.
You failed.
Well done.
Hey, well done.
You failed. You weren't gonna do it anyway.
Oh my God.
Also, failure is a good lesson. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you bounce back from failures. It's possible.
But to get a reward for it?
Yeah.
By the way, your mic picked up.
That's insanity. still thinking about the whore.
The whore.
Yeah, brother.
Story.
That happened. I'll never forget
that
it.
That means she got piped down while you were eating. And then got in her car. That's crazy that she beat you there.
That's what bothered me the most. I'm like, yo, you're not even
later that
night. Girl's not even from LA. Like, I knew where she was from. Uh-huh. I'm like, how the like, I know my city better than you. How'd you beat me here? I got food.
That's what you think. She got like Uber from the studio, like right in there.
Dog. No knock to her. The girl was on a hustle, but it blew my mind.
She got second dick before
hustle?
Your food digested.
That's what I'm saying. Hold on.
Is that a hustle?
Oh,
yes,
come on. Let's
yes,
not let's not act
yes,
crazy.
Fuck
but
it
I mean,
is
do you think she was the tier that was getting money for this, or you think it was just piped by?
This woman at that time was to the point where if she was affiliated with anyone of that stature, it made them look like that nigga too.
Is this somebody who's on now?
I wouldn't say on as on as she was. She never fell off though. She still looks good till today.
If I were to guess.
I'm not telling. You gotta confirm I'm not okay. telling. Damn it, I attacked him. I'm not telling it. Nah. I won't put my niggas or our business out there.
That's a messy biz.
Yeah, brother.
And I feel like both of them had to be aware of something.
I would hope.
You can't hide something that glaringly wild in your personality.
I feel like they don't care because it's just like,
no, of course they don't care.
You're not my chick, so like why am I tripping? If that's what
right,
you want
to
be treated like.
They have to know what type of shit you are. So at least in the back of your mind, you think like, all right, I guess she's going home now. Nope.
Yeah, they don't care. They don't care.
They don't think about it.
It's not. They ain't got the same heart as the three of us sitting up here.
My uncle said it the best. You don't pay a chick. You don't pay a hoe to fuck you. You pay her to leave. From that mentality, that's how you can tell. He's like, yo, every chick that
I have heard that before, but how's
every chick that walks out, you don't give a second thought to.
I mean, I ain't never paid for it. I don't want to ever have to get to that level. Thank God, I'm good.
Y'all keep saying that.
What?
Y'all keep saying that.
Saying what?
That y'all don't pay for it.
Oh, we're not going to. Let's have this discussion. Let's go ahead and talk about how a date and food equates
the exact
same
thing.
No, it's not.
Hey, can I have some pussy for $60, please?
Not the same.
Question. Did money come out of your pocket?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Was a transaction made?
No,
but do you know what a transaction is?
Yes, I do. Now, because of what she got out of it, it's on her.
Because
as Riley from the Boondock said, I could give her $60 and she can go cook a fucking meal.
You know what? I'm just going to say it. That's very rapey ways of thinking. I'm not even gonna lie. Because what Cleo and I are talking about is paying for things that get them to like us. Everybody Everybody leaves that part
out of it.
We pay for them. We pay for them to make the decision themselves.
Thank you.
I want his penis in my vagina.
Wow.
The whore is just who has $79.
Yo, chill.
So whoever equates that is the same person that's just like, well, I punched the sumbitch in the stomach and then I got what I wanted. It's like, fam, are you explaining this to me like it's okay? You ever had a dude explain like a borderline rapey story like it was regular and you're just like, nigga. You're weird.
And yet I didn't hear no difference between what the fuck he just said.
Come on.
I'm paying to convince you to do something.
Come on.
That's okay.
I gotta disagree with you on the
choices in my story.
There was this.
Yes, thank you, Cleo.
Why is there no choice in my story? Because she could say no.
I don't think taking a girl out to date is gonna be like this whole life
No, it's not that. It's not.
I got a lot of people on my side with this in these comments.
You're siding with the internet on something inappropriate. We're talking about something inappropriate. Now you're like, well, the YouTube comments, they got some stand-up people in there.
I don't know what the YouTube comments are saying. Don't bring them into this.
I'm just saying, just doing shit costs money. If we're gonna get something to eat for ourselves, that's gonna cost money. So if you're with them, you offer to pay for their money. I mean, for their food. Same thing with movies. Movies cost money. Whatever a date is costs money. You do it with them for the time. Just like you could potentially not spend any money and still get the ass.
Speak on it.
So what you're saying is you paying for time, right?
Oh, man. Oh, my God.
No.
Hold on. What did you just say? What are you
money is being spent while you're spending time together. You don't see the difference?
There's a difference between them.
Okay. I hope you see the difference. This is about to be. If we get any deeper into this, this is going to be a deposition.
Yo, chill.
They ain't going. I don't want them pulling up retro gaming in court.
No, it's crazy. Like, we're having this conversation, and I think there is a stigma regarding sex workers over the last like two years. That's been people have been trying to change it.
Hey, man, y'all leave my sex workers alone, okay?
Final Fantasy does not deserve this comment.
There's sex workers in Final Fantasy VII.
Right.
They're in the slums. Literally, one of the sections in this game is called the slums.
Yes.
Come on, brother.
This city looks like it got home.
It looks like some whore shit, yeah, for sure.
Okay? There's a whorehouse in Midgar.
And I'm not even talking about
there is. Age. Remember, Cloud has to cross-dress.
Because you know what makes cities go...
That's funny.
What makes
There's
cities...
There's a lot of cross-dressing in video games that didn't come off as cross-dressing. Yeah. It was like, I'm in disguise. It's like, why do you have a thong on? That's not even part of the disguise. You chose to do that.
One of the very first things people were concerned about, like, where we are culturally, will they put that part in the remake? And I still don't know if they're going to do it or not.
They should.
It should stay.
Because the two things that
make already.
A city go round and continue to go round is hospitals and strip clubs. That's what feeds the city.
That is some.
Am I lying?
That is some
Hold
Port
on.
Arthur
am I lying?
Pimping.
Am I lying?
Talk you just said.
But tell me, am I lying?
No, I don't think you're lying.
Okay then.
All right.
I'm just throwing it out there. I'm not saying it's right. I am just telling you what the world is.
Gotcha.
I don't trust this dude with this red do-rag.
That's Biggs.
I don't trust
him. If it's about your money, wait till we get back. I want my money now.
I don't like that he was inside you and said he ain't giving you your money.
Call J.G.
Speaking of transactions. Yeah, this does look like a hoary city.
Bruh, Aerith out here getting pushed to the ground. Like, yo, bruh, this is a slum.
Get out of my way, wench. Wench? Just call me a wench?
Her name
is Flower Girl.
Come on.
All right, what are we going to tell her? She asked what happened. Are we saying you better get out of
here? Nothing happened. What's up, girl?
I agree.
Hey.
Don't see many flowers around here. Oh, never mind. Are we macking on it?
Let's mac.
I'm with you on this.
I don't know even which one that was.
Oh, these. Do you like them? They're only one gil.
Gil is the money.
Yes, okay. It is. So, speaking of transactions, are you gonna buy the flower from her to make her like us?
This is right on time.
Yes, it is. Now, are you tricking?
What are you doing?
Trick.
You just got it. You just completed a mission, fam. Look it. Put it on my tab.
Here you are. She gives me a phone. And then she just walks away. And okay. Hey, wait. Hold on. Let me holler at you. Can I holler at you for a second?
You put the time in, though. Now she's going to remember you. Oh, there go that little blonde boy that helped me out.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, now you're chasing them. Fast forward.
I hate the crack vision.
We're out of it.
She's far gone, too.
Yeah, she's out.
All right, here come Jill.
So I got to go fight from Jill Valentine clones.
Low-key. A bunch of them look like very Resident Evil-esque.
Mm-hmm. I give it to you. You called that one. I've never put those two together at all.
Oh, yeah.
Goddamn Buster Swords with only two slots for material.
Cloud ran into prostitute. Magic, attack, or run.
Use potion and phoenix now.
Damn. Later. We out.
Jump them.
I'm trying to run.
Run. Nah, they come and get you. You know you got to fight.
Later, no,
you know you got to fight.
No, we out.
Nah, you stuck, bro.
No, watch this. Watch this. As far as you go, I don't have time to mess around with you guys. Enough babbling. Grab him.
Grab him and hold him.
Bend him over. Like, wait.
Yep, it seemed like that type of city too.
Yeah.
This city's old school.
And with that said, y'all, I think this is a great place to end this off. Thank y'all so much for joining us on the Final Fantasy VII. We need to keep doing this.
Absolutely.
Keep this going, especially with the new one coming out.
Yeah.
So
it's a walkthrough.
It is a walkthrough now. Yes, thank you for saying it. It is now officially a walkthrough. So This has been another episode of Retro Gaming. Stay tuned because up next is the fade.
The first already?
Let's get it.
Let's go.